kakhulu fellowship esinayo namhlanje sibona ine membership ikhulile kakhulu, ibandla is almost full. Siyabonga uNkulunkulu osiphe lamathuba lawo. This morning I want us to consider a very familiar passage. Very familiar passage to Christians. In fact, even non-Christians are familiar with this passage. The prodigal son story. Luke 15. So we're in Luke 15 this morning. Luke 15 is our text of consideration. Luke 15. I'll be reading from verse 11 through 32. Luke 15, from verse 11 through 32. It's a very familiar passage. Siyijwayele bazalwane. But before sibheke lokhu esizofunda esokunotha this morning. Ngifunda from the New King James Version, and it reads thus. Then he said, "A certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, 'Father, give me the portion of goods that fall to me.' So he divided to them his livelihood. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together, journeyed to a far country, and there wasted his possessions with prodigal living. But when he had spent all, there arose a severe famine in the land, and he began to be in want. Then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into his field to feed swine. And he would gladly have filled his stomach with the pods that the swine ate, and no one gave him anything. But when he came to himself, he said, 'How many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father and will say to him, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your servants." And he arose and came to his father. But when he was still a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion, and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said to him, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and in your sight, and am no longer worthy to be called your son." But the father said to his servants, "Bring one of the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and sandals on his feet. And bring the fatted calf here and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. For this my son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found." And they began to be merry. Now his older son was in the field. And as he came and drew near to the house, he heard music and dancing. So he called one of the servants and asked what these things meant. And he said to him, "Your brother has come, and because he has received him safe and sound. Your father has killed the fatted calf. But he was angry and would not go in. Therefore, his father came out and pleaded with him. So he answered and said to his father, "Lo, these many years I've been serving you. I never transgressed your commandment at any time. And yet you never gave me a young goat that I may make merry with my friends. But as soon as this son of yours came, who has devoured your livelihood with harlots, you killed the fatted calf for him." And he said to him, "Son, you are always with me, and all that I have is yours. It was right that we should make merry and be glad, for your brother was dead and is alive again, and was lost and is found." May the good Lord bless the reading of his word, even now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Shall we bow our heads and close our eyes as we pray? Baba wethu osezulwini, nonguyise wenkosi yethu uJesu. Lifundiwe nkosi izwi lakho, balalela abantwana bakho. Ngosisa nkosi ukufunda nokushunyela kwezwi lakho. Ngemboze Jehova ubuze bami, ngithethelele nkosi izono zami. Hlala Jehova ezindebeni zami. Nkulunkulu moya engcwele, khulume ngokwentando yakho. Ebese lonke udumo nenkazimulo kube kuwe Baba ngoKristu Jesu inkosi siyakhuleka. Amen.
Amen.
Well, this is our passage for today. Now, I have posed a few questions which I will throw at your face this morning. Rhetorical questions. I'm not expecting answers. Think about this. What if, this is hypothetically speaking, CIA is a parable, I've just read it, but hypothetically speaking, I want us to consider these four questions. In fact, there are more than four, but I'll just put these four as our basis of argument. What if the prodigal son, after having received the inheritance, went to a far country and traded successfully in business the inheritance and probably doubled the capital which he received from the father? How would the narrative have changed? Simas is someone who went out and squandered everything. As you read the story, every time you read the story, read what it says explicitly and also implicitly. Now, just imagine if he had after the inheritance, went out, traded. Suppose he did that ethically and being morally upright, without having this prodigal living. Just imagine. Wahamba to a far country, was phatha kahle, waba a good boy, le mali ayithathe kubaba, wafika laphayana and did business, and boom! Everything was successful, and after a while came back home, said, "Dad, when I left home with 2 million rands." Hey, what? 6 million. How would the narrative have changed? Now, I know that it might seem like we are stretching the parable too far, because this is a parable. Now, ngicela ukuyibeka lento. Remember the context of the parable. The context of the parable. Umuqala uLuke 15. ULuke 15 umuqala, there is an accusation against Christ that this man receives and dines with sinners. That's the accusation. So as you read the story, remember the story is a response to the accusation that Christ receives and died in sinners. Is that what about doing?
Amen.
So, singalahleki context of the story. Now, nansi ke ke sengibekile proposition yokuqala. Hypothetically speaking, what if wahamba wa trader and made money too? What if wakwenza lokho ephila futhi impilo right, upright, ethical, yonke ihamba kahle? How would the narrative have changed? Three, what if Waitat inheritance went into a far country and squandered it through prodigal living? But just when he paid, boom, in his gambling spree, he hits a jackpot, he triples the inheritance. Immoral living, prodigal living, squandering the property, but just before it was depleted, boom, in his gambling spree, why triple-ish? Abu Yekai after a while. It's a proof, I want it, what went wrong? But Nancy Mark, I can't have it now. I've tripled it. Think about these questions. Or lastly, what if he cashed the inheritance from the father quietly, secretly squandered it without leaving home? What if he cashed it? Why divide Baba amongst them? Say Tati Lelemali never left the premises, but secretly and quietly squandered it. Corner lemak again. Now, if you think these hypothetical questions are off tangent, if you think we have stretched the parable too far, you must consider the brother's concern. What was the brother's concern? A seafood. The brother's concern. Verse 25. Now his older son was in the field, and as he came and drew near to the house, he heard music and dancing. So he called one of the servants and asked what these things meant. And he said to him, your brother has come, and because he has been received safe and sound, your father has killed the fetid calf. Lalela, gifunumuzwe ke manje. The father goes out, pleading with him, ukuthi ngena phela, come join us as we celebrate. Uyanqaba. It's yini concern yakhe? Nansi ke iconcern yakhe. He says, verse 29, so he answered and said to his father, lo, these many years I have been serving you. I never transgressed your commandment at any time, and yet you never gave me a young goat that I may make merry with my friends. Lalelare, verse 30. But as soon as this son of yours came, who has devoured your livelihood with harlots, you killed the fatted calf. There's the concern. The other brother is concerned about the property that was lost. Go with again. This one is wasteful. And he wasted everything out there. I've been around the premises, I've been serving you faithfully, and I kept all your commandments, but you have never given me even a young goat to make merry and celebrate with my friends. He had a point, a valid point for that matter. Now, what would have been his argument had the younger brother came back with the property multiplied? Because his concern was that he wasted everything away. Mm. Are we still together? It is on those bases that hypothetically I've put these four propositions to you. Ngoba ubhuti omdala ukhala ngokuthi umoshile lona, umoshe wamoshe wamoshe, usafika lana ungcolile, ufika lana uyanuka, esefika lana engasaphethe lutho, esesikwandarisha yonke into ngale nalabo sisters abadayisa ngethempeli. Suddenly usebuya lana, besefika lana jiki jiki, sesiyamjabulela, sekushaya amaphasi, sekuzwa njani? Ngeke ngeke, I never. Now, if you think these questions are off tangent, let me tell you something before Scooby the story. Is it possible? Is it really possible that we can cash in from the Father, move away from the Father, and be successful away from the Father? Uma ucabanga ukuthi that is impossible, you might need to reconsider. Experience has taught me. I've seen people who are successful. They are living their dream lives away from the Father. It's possible. It's possible. Trust me, it is possible to go out and trade and be successful with the Father's inheritance without being in the Father's presence. Ngiyabazi ke, noma ungabazi ngiyabazi. Ba right, their marriages are stable, their businesses are thriving, life is good, they have sound health, sound, they are fine, they are doing exceedingly well without the Father. It's possible. Well, oh, by the way, it is also possible to be morally upright and ethical away from home. I know them. They are trading successfully in business, but writing and yonke into bayenzele writing, impilo bayiphila ngendlela yona. Morally they are upright, yonke into bayenza kahle and yonke into ihlangene, but Jesus has nothing to do with all of it. They are doing it away from home. It's possible. Well, it is also possible that abanye bayahamba and they live this prodigal living, and somehow towards the end of their lives, away from home, right? It is possible to squander and recover away from home. So things cannot only be recovered at home. They cannot only be enjoyed at home, otherwise we will be too ambitious of ourselves to think that the Christians are the only people who are happy in life. They are happy out there. And if you think we are the only ones who are successful, you might need to reconsider your assumptions and your presuppositions. I know people who are happy, they are stable, life is good out there, away from the Father. Now, if that is the case, what is our mission to those people? What gospel, what do we preach to such people? I'll tell you a story that prompted me to reconsider the music when I found that differently. I'll tell you a story. It's a true story, ne? It's a true story. I might have shared it in the time past, but there's nothing wrong about repeating the same story. A friend of mine, Pastor Mulenga, Zambian, when I was doing my undergrad, he was doing his master's. This one particular day, we were sharing the same house. So, this one particular day, this day, why you got there? Why is it like agency? Now, this particular day, I'm telling agency, I'm Muslim, in one of the palaces in Berkshire, around where Newport College is. Now, this palace belongs to the Saudi Arabian Queen. Now, the Saudi Arabian queen, she would occasionally visit this palace in England. She comes in her private jet. She will land at the Heathrow Airport. Commercial flights will be on one side. There is an area designated for her at Heathrow Airport. She would land her private jet. As she landed her private jet, there is a convoy of cars already waiting for her to escort her to the palace. Uma palace. Every time she arrives to the palace, there is brand new linen. She never repeats the linen. If Ezra for 2 weeks in England, by the way, she's got many of these palaces. Another one in Australia, another one in America, she's got palaces. Now, my favorite Lana, she would occasionally come if she has meetings with these elite high-profile people. So, I get cashew of a mulem, I get a bona bundle of a tafula. Tafula cool, a loo, you shake. So, I have a lot of chicken and whip. Now, look, there are fruits, organic fruits, 100% organic fruits. Hamba hamba zaphela ba uqala amastatus uhamba hamba kube main course kube yini kube yini so usezophela ngama desserts itafula that could feast easily 500 to 700 people uthola uyena labantu ababili yho. Now as behamba lana bayaxoxa bahamba bayagwaza bayafaka empentini bayagwaza baxoxa ipaki la bahamba bakuxoxa babandle abantu baphinde babuye etafuleni badle imili yakhona inasikhathi yadliwe nje kudliwe xoxe kuyothi ma sebeqedile leyo lunch leyo then the workers would come and eat ma sebeqeda ukudla everything must be disposed ayikho into ebekwayo konke kuyochithwa by the way umela for 2 weeks. That will be happening for 2 weeks until ahambe and visit another. So umebuya endlini umulela. Ungena endlini ungena ngecala. Uthe ndoda vuka nivuke ngihlala. Uthi tell me something. What could you preach to such a one? Yilo lesho maye. And ithi ngoma esivule ngayo. Ikhuluma ngani? This is a girl. You could walking in the streets of gold. She's not interested in the streets of gold. She has them here. You talk about mansions. She has palaces. That gospel will send to those who are subjected to abject poverty, but not to that queen. Never. Now, Carl Schumann, the woods. Don't you want to hear the message? Who's off to this hour? What's even in the world of organic? 100%. Uzongena ngani yathi message uzongena kuyini uzongena ngani nomizwe lwiz ukuphla uzongena ngakhona which message would you preach to her? No, we have to tackle these issues because as a church there is an audience out there that we can't tap into because we have this gospel only suitable for those who are yabuya. What's happening in this story? Let's unpack it and close it down. Uthini ubuntu omdala? Uthi ubuntu omdala, this your son took your livelihood, father, and he went away and squandered it through prodigal living with harlots. Yet you receive him gladly and you throw a party and you expect all of us to join in and be merry. No, never. I won't join in that party. He wasted everything. Now listen to me very carefully. Give me a slow motion. Sin. Listen to this one. Sin is not squandering of property. Sin is rebellion. Sin is not squandering of property. Though you don't because that is not sin. Sin was not in squandering the property. Sin is rebellion. And what is rebellion? The younger son refused to act and live as a son. That's the crux of the matter. That's the gist of the matter. Sin is rebellion. And sin is not the squandering of property. The younger son refused to live and act as a son. So it's immaterial what happened of the inheritance. Whether he multiplied it or whether he lost it, that's immaterial. The gist of the matter is that he left the father. Alienation is sin, not property. Our theology has been like that of the elder brother. The elder brother is concerned about property lost, while the father is concerned about a son lost, who has lost his title as a son. That is why when the younger son comes back home, the father, he doesn't question him about the property that has been lost, but he quickly restores him to the title that he lost as a son, hence the robe, hence the ring, hence the sandals, which were of the title of the son, only due to the son. But if the visit is a long time, ubugi bagadili bagadili lakagile, wayu baba, ubugi dotane lakagile. Our theology is property oriented, like that of the elder brother. When we sell the kingdom of God, we sell heaven. Clap plates. There are plates of gold. There are this and that and that. Well, it might appeal to some. It does not appeal to everybody. For some, that's useless. It's for you. That is why some people, because that's misunderstood, they think Christians are just a bunch of lazy people. I'm telling you the honest truth. Other people think Christians, that's a bunch of lazy people. But full of servants. That's what I receive. I receive. That's all they know. I receive. Why? Because we have sold this gospel which is property oriented. What happened in Eden? What did we lose in the Garden of Eden? We did not lose property. Yes, we did lose property, but that's not the main issue. In the Garden of Eden, we lost fellowship with the Father. We lost communion with the Father. We were alienated from God. If you eat of this fruit, I'm telling you, you will starve for life. You will surely die. Alienation binds all of us, whether you own castles and private jets or what, or whether you are subjected to poverty. Alienation binds us all. Now, in the Bible, he said, as a church, do we have a message of restoration? Alienation. Judgment. First, we made a judgment a couple of Sabbaths ago. If you can, try by all means to secure food while you are here. You need food here. I'm dead serious. As much as it's possible, try and secure a house here. You desperately need it. Get a degree. Do that business. You need it here. Our sufficiency in heaven will not be derived from the abundance of food.
Okay.
Gas cooler, Nana Masailos, Amakoma, Akolo, that could last us a millennium. No! Our suffering. sufficiency will be derived from the proximity of the Father. That because the Father is here, it is no way that my next meal is not guaranteed. Ukuba khona kuhamba ukuba seduze no baba ozongenza ngikhululeke hayi uboni ukudla kuyinqwaba ngiyazi uma ubaba enayiduze ngeke ngingadli kuthi la ngithi ukudla kuzoba khona ngoba ubaba ukhona. Our safety and security in heaven will not be the 12 gates. No. Our safety and security is derived from the presence of the Father. That nothing can touch me in the presence of the Father. Amen. Latin gospel, which is property oriented. Latin, if you can hear, it's not being the CC7. This property oriented gospel. You know, see your toilet, see your toilet, see your toilet. Now, the understand. Look at the turning point of the story. Where is the turning point? Vulukape. He went away, he squandered everything. There arose a severe famine in that land. What happened? He went and joined himself to the one of the citizens of that country. Lalela, lalela. Umfana had no interest of going back home. Ingoba kwasephelile. Sometimes the worst thing that could happen to people is for them to become successful away from their family. Because they will never sense a need of going back home. The best thing that happened to this young man was for everything to be depleted. No, but his speech is up. He was going back home for the wrong reasons. Now, I could love his speeches. I could have a writing. I'm not so much concerned about the title, so long as my belly is secure. Forgive my servants. Still, I'm a simple card. If you understand, some of us have been restored to the kingdom by the through wrong motives. Abanye, sibuyile sisembusweni kaNkulunkulu. Abanye, sibuye sezembusweni ngoba sishayile umhlaba. Not because we were yearning and longing for the presence of the Father. We did not feel that alienation until things went wrong in the far country. And going along was the best thing that happened in our lives. Ngoba Gapela. He did not come back to his senses at some time. No! What's the pen in the foot of the corner? No, man. Let me go back home and take the title of a servant. I'm not interested in that one. I'm interested to restore you to your former glory. I'm interested to restore you to your former glory. Eli Vangeli, let's show my life. I listen to reconcile the Mazadan. Lord, I have to umanje ungekho uNkulunkulu impilo lezi zihlanganele yeke leyo yeke kapsayishumayela obusuyazi manje ukuthi ayihambi kanjani siyekene siphumele kuyona le ndaba yokucabanga ukuthi abantu abalekho Christ abekho happy bani bahappy le nto ecabanga ukuthi impilo zabo azikho stable iyaba stable impilo away from God. But the thing is, when the Father in the consummation of the kingdom, Konabani will be alienated from him. Moral, as they were on earth, upright, ethical in all their conduct, but they'll still be alienated from God. Konabani is going to speak at God through a property-oriented gospel. The elder brother was concerned in the rock. Ubaba umesefika akasekhulumi ngisho ukuyikhuluma leyo. And by the way, yabona, when the son approaches the father,
ubaba uyagijima uza kuyena and uma efika eza kuyena esasiqala ispeech sakhe forgiveness was issued. Forgiveness was issued. He did not respond to the speech. Forgiveness. When the father offered forgiveness, yes, Uguti, your kind of forgiveness, my kind of forgiveness, should be initiated by the offender. But according to the narrative, it is the offended who takes an initiative to offer forgiveness. Uzi atu Jesu. No, before you go and worship, don't be quick to come and worship. Umuthi angena sabathe ukhayibo esiphala ngisiphamba nesiphambali. Asakabuyisana. Uthi hayi noma mangena, nami ngakushonisa ba school, drive back. Go back and be reconciled with the offender, which means whether you are the offended, the one who takes the initiative to set up the reconciliation process is the offended. Hayi lo ogilile, ilo giliwe okuyena. Oqalisa indlela yami yokubuyisana. Now, this man, he receives and dines with sinners. Uthi, yes, you are right, because this man has lost his sons and daughters and he's reconciling them back to their original tag. It is for that reason the man is concerned. Uthi, my children have been alienated from me. The father is not so much concerned about this property thing. Think about that one. Think about that one. Think about that one. Forgiveness. Forgiveness. Forgiveness is not merited. Offered on the basis of grace. It's grace, not merited. Look, Bob, I've been serving you all these years. In fact, when he was even coming from the fields, would have been serving you all these years, and I've kept your commandments faithfully, yet, you have never even slaughtered a young goat for me, for my friends to enjoy. Why? Now, the elder brother, he says, Mina, I have done X, Y, and Z for you, but you have not rewarded me for these things that I have done for you. Yet this one, he receives your grace unmerited. There you go. You've got it right, son. You've got it right. This forgiveness is not merited. It's not on the basis of what you have done.
Yeah.
Uthi asikho isikhathi bengizodlula lapho because the way we preach is seemingly contrary to that. It's seemingly contrary to that at times when the gospel is misunderstood. No! Lo mdala! Angithi! Ngihlebele! Ngihlebele ngoba ngoba sasiyavala. Ngihlebele! Angithi! Nina! Ndelo kuyikhipha lana. Angithi nina. Nithi mase sifike ezulwini. Vunizwa kahle le. Mase sifike ezulwini. Hele wami. Uyokukhombisa ukuthi ngisebenza kangakanani. Obaba umphele shale inkanyezi ezinqaba masidaza inqaba ushaye ngamatsha inqaba akhomba ukuthi ngisebenza kangakanani. Somehow as to imply that the crown, that the crowns that we shall receive, the stones are the experiences of the saints. They are the experiences of the saints, what they went through, not a reward of what they have done. No one in the heaven, as it were, you did 1, 2, 3, 4, therefore, no. And anybody should pass, that's your preparation, you notice.
salvation. The Lamb of God that was slain before the foundation of the earth. Isivulela sonke. Noma sahlulela ngithi siyazi ukuthi kwahlulela kwethu. Hayi ngoba sahlulela kahle kahle vele sekwahlulelile. Ingakho abantu babe siyahambela abantu babelisana. Ake siyacanga ukuthi sizoyeka manje. Siyeke le property oriented. Because be not comfortable while alienated from God.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what you're doing, even if you're prospering in a far country. Go back home. Go back home. Go back home. Abeka abantu who are in a far country are doing well. They might be seemingly doing well in your sight. They are alienated from the Father. Bring them back home. Bring them back home. May the good Lord bless you and keep you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.